Approximately 500,000 people in the United States alone rely on a powered wheelchair for mobility. Of these, 15% are unable to operate traditional joystick controls. My lab is building intelligent powered wheelchairs that assist drivers in operating their powered wheelchair. What we are hoping to do is add assistive technology, like driverless car, AI technology to powered wheelchairs to offload some of that control burden from the person over to the machine. One of our partners on this project is Kevin Rowland. Kevin is an engineer and a computer scientist, and he is living with ALS. He currently communicates using his eyes, and he also drives his powered wheelchair using his eyes. He's written code for our project using his eyes. Kevin now has access to assisted driving through his wheelchair, and because he's a part of our team and because he's a hacker, he's also going to be able to develop and help us improve and test and beta test and modify these assistance paradigms that we've been developing in my lab. We've been developing two specific technologies in collaboration with our partners. One of these is an assistance paradigm that we call React, which will react to a person's control command and just what's immediately in the environment. So if you wanted to go straight and there's an obstacle right in front of you, it can actually help steer you around that obstacle. We're also developing what we call roboticist, and this is a higher level of assistance where the robotic wheelchair will be able to drive the human operator wherever they would like to go autonomously. The wheelchair builds up a map of a known environment, like your home. We can then add tags to this map where you can tag and say, this is where I like to sit and watch TV. This is the kitchen. This is the bathroom. And then after the fact, a person can now select one of these known locations and say, drive me there. And the wheelchair will do it all by itself. It is very grounding and very motivating to get your research to translate out into the real world.